Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to my Arsenal rebuilding save. I don't normally do this, but I'm gonna start with the team that I support in real life, which is Arsenal. I know, haha. But I thought I'm gonna give it a try in FM21. We skipped past the first season, so we started just before the 2021-2022 season. Sure enough, the game placed Arsenal in 8th, like in real life. So lucky for us, we're gonna be in the position Arsenal is actually in right now before starting the new season. Without worrying about European football, we're just gonna focus on the Premier League and obviously the domestic cups. However, the domestic cups are not important. Board is not gonna judge us on the Emirates FA Cup or the Carabao EFL Cup. We just have to do one thing, get the team back into the Champions League. So we just have to qualify for the Champions League, guys. As you can see, the importance is required, so they expect us to qualify for the Champions League. And this is why I'm here, have to get the team back to the Champions League. Now, being a rebuilding process, even though I usually start and continue at least until the winter transfer window with the same players, I thought this is a huge opportunity for me to put my own stamp on the club and the squad. And basically, I changed like 70-80% of the squad, so I will walk you through it. First, let's have a look at the transfer. I've never been so active in a transfer ever. Okay, so I brought in Fabian, Spanish international from Napoli. We paid 40 million. Can go up to 45 depending on bonuses. I brought Carlos Soler from Valencia for 30 million. João Pedro, Brazilian wonder kid from Watford. Danny Ings, surprising or not, Danny Ings was placed on the transfer list by Southampton. He was highly recommended by all my scouts, as you can see, for a start half. Even though I'm not a star rating man, his attributes look really good as well, so I thought, why not? I brought in Januzaj. He's very tricky, very fast, great vision as well. I think he can help us. Odriozola to replace Bellerin from Real Madrid. I think he's better all around than Hector, so I let Hector Bellerin go. I brought Cengiz Under, even though he might be injury prone, guys. His attributes are just off the charts. I really think he's gonna help us. I brought in Luis Felipe, which I was really impressed by. His attributes are amazing, so hopefully he can do a very good job. Also, he's gonna partner Gabriel, so the Brazilian center back partnership. I hope it's gonna work well. Dragoski from Fiorentina to provide depth in between the sticks. He's only 23, very young for a goalkeeper. Caligari, the new Cafu, hopefully. Or I would be happy with the new Dani Alves, whatever. He looks really good for his age and his potential is obviously off the charts. Iheanacho placed on a transfer list. I think he can do a job for us for one, maybe two seasons until my wonder kids really start to develop properly. Yeah, he was on the transfer list. We got him with 10 million. I think he can provide good depth. Dominik Livakovic in goal, a Dinamo Zagreb goalkeeper. He looks really good. Got rid of Leno. There we go. Matias Arezzo from River Plate Montevideo. Unfortunately, we're still waiting for his work permit to come through. I sent him on loan to Borussia Dortmund. And Luca Pellegrini on loan. This was because I actually brought in a few players at left back, but they are too young to make an impact on the first team. So I just loaned in Luca Pellegrini from Juventus just to give them that extra year to develop and then come into the first team. But a very solid left back. Who did we get rid of? Maitland-Niles went to Marseille, Xhaka went to Sevilla, Bellerin to PSG, Nicolas Pepe to Girondins de Bordeaux, Lacazette to Sevilla, Leno to Freiburg, Cedric to Sevilla as well, Chambers to Hamburg, Kolasinac, David Luiz, Runarsson as well, and a whole bunch of loans, including some well-known players like William Saliba, Matias Arezzo and Youssouf Demir, Nketia, Ruggeri, and a bunch of others. So our net spend, guys, was 77 million. We still have money though, almost 30 million in the bank, 750k to spare in wages. So I think it's really good. Yeah, this is the squad, guys. I try to obviously have at least two players in each position. I think I done just that. Obviously Papeete, I try to loan him out because he's too young to play a part this season. But because Gabriel and Luis Felipe are the Brazil Olympic squad, we are lacking a center back. So Papeete is gonna step in. We're gonna play a 4-4-2, guys. I think it's the first time I'm playing a 4-4-2 because we have so many good strikers as well. This is how the initial team and how I envision it will look. So it's a pretty basic tactic, classic 4-4-2 formation. I still kept a few players like Gabriel, Tierney, Saka, Partey and Aubameyang. 5 players survived the overhaul, for now at least. Obviously Aubameyang is getting to the end of his career, but I think he can still be very useful for us for at least 1 or 2 seasons. This is how the team will look initially. Obviously, if someone that's not in the first 11 will start performing, they can easily slide in the first 11. Surprising or not, Danny Ings is supposed to be the star of the team. See, he's taking a slight backseat to Aubameyang because Danny Ings is an advanced forward as well, but he's gonna sacrifice himself playing as a deep line forward. Now, for the schedule, We played a lot of friendlies to get match sharpness up and ready for the new season, and we made quite a bit of money by organizing this friendly cup competition. But this is our start, guys. We're gonna start with Norwich City at home. Norwich, a newly promoted side. We're going to Leicester. This is supposed to be a tricky fixture. Southampton at home, Leeds United away from home, and the Carabao Cup game in between. I am actually really optimistic, really intrigued how we're gonna do, because such a major overhaul in the squad and players will need to gel in. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. Although for this first game of the season, I'm gonna play Saka as a complete wingback on support and Jan Ujai as an inverted winger on attack, because we are favorites for this game and I'm expecting us to dominate proceedings and be in control of the game and put them under pressure, and obviously expecting a good win in the end. What a start from Man City, 6-0 against Southampton. Come on, guys, we have to start well. We have to hit the ground running. Go on, Pierre! Oba! And Danny Ings picks up the pieces. First goal of the season, it's gonna be Danny Ings for us. Aubameyang did the hard part. Did everything right except the finish, which was unlucky. Hit the post. Danny Ings was there to pounce. 1-0 for the Arsenal. Januzaj! Anan Januzaj, first goal of the season, Aubameyang with the assist. Ah, that's really good vision. Januzaj makes it look easy as well. Aubameyang has two assists. That first one counted as an assist as well. It was his shot that was deflected from the post to Danny Ings. Oh, Januzaj, what a goal! Anan Januzaj! Jesus, this is a very good surprise. Fabian with that vision, but Januzaj completely takes this game from the scruff of his neck. But I guess when you have so much quality, it makes life easier. Only Livakovic saves us. They could have gotten one back just before halftime. Rob Holding gets his goal from a Januzaj cross as well. I thought it was Pablo Mari, but there you go, it's Rob Holding. That should be a red card. Yeah, it is a red card. And it's gonna end 4-0 in the end, guys. We didn't force after I got the man sent off for the first last half an hour. The game ended 4-0, but impressive. We restricted them to only one shot on target just before halftime. Livakovic has done very well to keep that out. But a lot of positives. Obviously, the most impressive was Januzaj with two goals and an assist. It's a very, very positive start. But then again, we have to take it with a pinch of salt, guys. We have played against Norwich. They are just a newly promoted team. We don't have to get ahead of ourselves. Okay, guys, second game of the season. We're going to the King Power Stadium to take on Leicester City. This, I expect, to be a very tough test. We are still without Luis Felipe and Gabriel. They are on holiday after representing their country, Brazil, to the Olympic Games. They've done that very well. Not only did Brazil win the Olympic Games, they were the partnership in the center of the defense, and they both got into the team of the tournament. So that's very good for them and for Brazil, but it's not amazing for us because now they will be missing this very important game. So it's going to be Holding and Pablo Mari at center back. Tierney is back, but he's lacking match sharpness. He's not fully fit, but we need him. We definitely need him. I prefer Januzaj takes the nod instead of Bukayo Saka, because he has done so well in the first game. Other than that, yeah, I'm curious to see how we're gonna do. Oh, Thomas Partey with a masterpiece. What a strike that was from Thomas. Whoa. See here, Fabian gets his pass cut through by Ndidi, but Thomas Partey, whoa, what a strike. And it's 1-0 for the Arsenal. Oh, Carlos Soler, what a strike and what a through ball that was for Thomas Partey. If the first game belonged to Adnan Januzaj, this game belongs to Thomas Partey. He's having a blast out there, look at that. Soler makes the right run and first time finish. No chance for Schmeichel. Oh, it's a penalty. Oh, it's gonna be reviewed by the VAR. Danny Ings, I think he was brought down by James Maddison. Good counter-attacking play by Danny Ings. And it's a penalty! It's a penalty for the Arsenal. Who's gonna take it? Is it Aubameyang? Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang! It's 3-0. Again, we lead 3-0 at half time. What an amazing display, guys. Oh, Livakovic is having a great game out there. I can't believe it, guys. What a start of the season. And considering we haven't played our starting center backs, we kept 2 clean sheets from 2 games. I believe that's quite impressive. Maybe not as impressive in the Norwich game, because it was at home against a newly promoted side. However, to win 3-0 at Leicester. Okay, guys, third game of the season, Southampton at home. We have good news and bad news. The good news are the center back partnership of Luis Felipe and Gabriel is back and running. The bad news is Kieran Tierney is gonna miss yet another game through injury. He got a slight knock in training and he's not gonna be able to play because we're playing Southampton at home. Southampton is having a miserable start of the season with 2 losses out of their first 2 opening games, especially in the opening fixture of the season. They got destroyed by Man City at the Etihad 6-0. That's why we're playing Saka as a complete wingback on support to complement Januzaj on that left hand side. And yeah, we're looking to win, guys, and build on our very positive start of the season. Oh, go on, Abba. Oh, play Danny, man. Play Danny Ings in and it's 1-0. Go on, Danny. Go on, Danny. Oh, super Danny Ings, the second goal of the season. He opened the scoring in the first game against Norwich as well. But what a beautiful counter-attack. Aubameyang releases Danny Ings, but what a strike that is. Against his former club as well. Well, he didn't celebrate, but he doesn't need to. What a strike. Go on, Abba. Yes. Go on, Super Danny. Super Danny Ings, guys. What a transfer. I want to thank my scouts. Because they highly recommended this guy. Look at that. Selfish, but every striker is selfish, so I get it. It's a very, very good start. We are looking so, so dangerous on the counter. And Super Danny Ings denied the Forster. He could have got his hat-trick in the first half. Oh, what a pass that is from Fabián Ruiz to find Aubameyang. Clinical. Absolutely clinical. Yeah, too much space for Fabián Ruiz. He just picks up the pass. Aubameyang is not gonna miss from there. We have 2 killers up front. It's refreshing because I've never played with 2 out-and-out strikers. Oh, they do not miss, guys. They do not miss these chances. They absolutely... Go on, Januzaj. Oh, by himself. Oh, hits the post. Unlucky. No, don't concede. Well done. Dani. Soler. Aubameyang. 5-0 for the Arsenal. What a strike that is. First time finish from Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. Dani Ings. Martinelli finds Under. First goal for the Arsenal. For Cengiz Under. And Martinelli gets his assist. We destroyed them, guys. We absolutely destroyed them. Ripped them apart. They lost 6-0 in the first game against City. They're losing 6-0 against us as well. Southampton might struggle to avoid relegation this season. Yeah, everybody played amazingly well, especially the 2 up front. Aubameyang got his hat-trick. Danny Ings maybe unlucky not to do so, but a lot of positives. Okay, guys, we're going to Bristol City in the Carabao Cup. We're treating this as serious as we can without any starters in the first 11. It's a very good opportunity for the players that are not usually playing to impress me and obviously look for a starting spot in the future. The substitutes should still win this game quite comfortably. It's their chance to impress, guys, so hopefully they will. It's very crowded in there. But Under finds the back of the net, but what an amazing through ball that was. Guendouzi does amazing to pick him up. Look at that ball from Guendouzi. That's why I trust him. That's why he's still here. Oh, Martinelli with a great solo goal. This reminds me of the Danny Ings goal, but what a goal this is. Starting from his own half, one-on-one with the defender, made light work of him. beaten the goalkeeper as well. 2-0. Very good, solid performance, guys. 2-0 win. I was never in doubt. A lot of positives. However, there were some negatives as well. Lucas Torreira was forced off with an injury. Then we got knocks for Cengizun there and Caligari as well. And hopefully it's nothing serious, but you don't want to see this. Yeah, Lucas Torreira, it's a bad one. 5-6 weeks. Caligari, 2 to 3 weeks. And Under, only 1 or 2 days. Okay, guys, we are in front of our last game of the episode. Hopefully we're gonna make it a perfect episode. I don't remember having a perfect episode in which I win every game. Well, we are in a good position to do just that. We're going to Leeds United, we're going to Elland Road, and it's a Leeds United without Marcelo Bielsa. Bielsa resigned from Leeds to take over Spurs, our biggest rival, so that's never gonna happen in real life. But we're in a good position to beat them. They haven't made a good start of the season. They are lying in 18th currently, and they have a caretaker manager, so they are there for the taking, guys. I feel we're in a good run of form. Obviously, Tierney is not up to speed like usual, but slowly but surely he needs to get on and fix his injury struggles, because we need him. He's such a good player, such a good player when fit. Oh, Soler, what a chance that is. You need to score that, brother. Konoba. Oh, I think it's a penalty. Can it be? Can it be a penalty? Penalty awarded, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. What now for the Arsenal? Fifth goal of the season for Abba. In case you're wondering why he has the number 7 t-shirt, guys, it's his favorite number, so he asked for it. Oh yes, he's running the show, Fabian Ruiz. Beautiful, 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 beautiful. Januzaj with a perfectly placed free kick, far post, Fabian, first time finish, no chance for Melie. Oh, Danny Ings, I thought he's gonna square it for Alba, but no, he's a goal scorer, guys. He took it himself, 3-0. We concede our first goal of the season, guys. It's finally happening. Rafinha scores from a Rodrigo assist. Oh, don't. Please don't. Don't give me a hard time. Please don't give me a hard time. Oh, Livakovic saves us from a nervy end of the game. And there we have it, guys. 3-1 win at Elland Road. A lot of positives. 3-0 at halftime, like usual. But a few negatives as well. Our fullbacks were not up for it. 6-4, both of them. Not what I want to see. Odriozola is one of the very few signings that didn't hit the ground running. He's not looking comfortable, but obviously he needs some time to adapt to the new league, the new team, new tactics, and so on. But Tierney is still struggling for fitness. That's why he's struggling to perform as well. Hopefully, slowly but surely, he's gonna come good. But yeah, good win in the end. Well, this was it for today's episode, guys. I think we've done much, much better than what I expected. As you can see, we are top of the league, but we played one more game. Let's have a look at the results. We've done amazingly well, I believe. 4-0 against Norwich at home in the opening game. 3-0 at the King Power Stadium against Leicester. 6-0 against Southampton. We won in the Carabao Cup with the substitutes, Bristol, and we won at Leeds. Obviously, I'm not gonna get overexcited like all our Arsenal fans do. It is a very good start. However, we play teams that normally don't do very well, like Norwich, Southampton, both games at home. Leeds are not going through a good period without Marcelo Bielsa. They are sitting in 18. But the win at Leicester, it's what's really giving me a lot of confidence as well. So I'll take a lot of confidence from today and from our opening month of the season. I expect at least to win the games I have at home next episode. And probably even a draw at Man United should be fine. But other than that, Aubameyang is having a blast. Most goals for us, most assists. Livakovic is a bossing goal. I love him. Fabian with 3 assists. Anyway, if you have enjoyed the video, please smash that like button. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already for more content. And I shall see you next episode. Take care.